Like Laurie Witkop, most bow hunters and many gun hunters today hunt from tree stands. And if you hunt on public lands, you'll see more bucks if you put your stand where other hunters are unlikely to go. Here's Michael Murphy of Whitetail Sanctuary Solutions with some advice on choosing a good spot for a stand on public land.
There's a lot of information out there for you to utilize to determine that perfect spot for your hunting stand. One of the options you have is aerial views, contour maps. You can get those on Google, you can find it on the internet, you can go to map stores, and there's many phone apps as well. Once you've collected that information, first thing you want to do is look at a spot where no other hunters want to go. The number one thing that mature bucks avoid is human pressure. So you're looking for a spot that's not easy to get to. If that has an elevated area that's surrounded by water and you have to walk through water to get there, that could be a great location for a mature buck to bed. An island in the middle of a marsh is an ideal location for a stand. Look for natural pinch points that funnel deer into an area like this well-used trail with woods to the right and a thick swampy area to the left. This is a great location for a stand. When you're looking at that public property to hunt, don't overlook a great piece of information that's out there, and that's the private landowner that lives nearby. Meet with those neighboring property owners to determine how the deer are accessing that land and get them a gift certificate as a thank you. Now that you have this information, you can utilize this to take that large hunting parcel and reduce it down by 75% to determine your scouting area. Scouting public land is a must. Be prepared for a long walk and wear the gear that you're going to wear when you're hunting so you work all the kinks out before that hunt. Do your homework and you will be rewarded.
Deer numbers vary from region to region and even from one county to the next depending on available habitat, agricultural crops, and past harvest. Overall, though, our deer herd's in great shape, and Wisconsin continues to be a national leader in record book entries. And there are ample opportunities to see and harvest deer in most parts of the state. Here's a forecast for the upcoming gun deer season provided by deer biologists from around the state. Northern Wisconsin has a variety of habitats, from farmland to large blocks of forest, and deer numbers vary across the region. Last winter, some areas saw mild conditions, while others experienced their second severe winter in a row. Forest, Northern Marinette, and Northern Oconto counties have bucks only hunting this fall. In all other counties of the region, some antlerless tags are available. Areas that experienced mild to moderate winter conditions last year can expect to see an increase in deer numbers, but areas where the winter was severe last year, you'll see fewer deer this year. Heavy snow during last year's gun season in parts of the north decreased the harvest, so hunters can expect to see more mature bucks there this year. Spring greenup was early, quick, and lush, providing much needed forage for winter-stressed deer, which appears to have helped fawn production across the north. Public land is abundant in county, state, and national forest, and hunters looking for new areas to hunt on public land should seek out 5 to 10-year-old aspen clear cuts and areas with a lot of mature oaks, as this year's acorn crop was another good one. Most of the Northeast District experienced 6 mild winters in a row, and there was strong fawn production this year throughout the region. Habitat ranges from northern hardwood forest to flatter agricultural and wetlands complexes in Winnebago, Fond du Lac, and Calumet counties. In most of the district, you'll be allowed from 1 to 5 antlerless authorizations, and biologists are urging you to take at least 1 antlerless deer where this is allowed. Preseason scouting is a good idea, as high water along the Lake Michigan and Green Bay shorelines and in forested wetlands will make access difficult in some places.